Leia here from leiafirstsci.com/MCAT, and in this video, I'm going to show you how you can quickly and easily determine which kinematic equation to use when faced with an MCAT physics problem. For detailed tutorials on the individual topics and concepts, including work-through practice problems, catch my entire series on translational motion by visiting my website leiafirstsci.com/MCATphysics. You may see many different forms of the kinematic equations, but if you understand them and work through them, you'll recognize that these are the four main equations that you have to know. For detailed breakdown on these equations and more, grab my MCAT kinematic cheat sheet on my website, leiafirstsci.com/MCATphysics. So let's go through them one at a time to show you how you can rewrite them and understand the different forms of the same equation that you'll see. Starting with the first one, notice that we have x final is equal to x initial plus vt. If your problem starts at x equals 0, you may drop the x and simply have the form x is equal to vt. You may also see this written as x is equal to v average times t. Say we wanted to take the average of a and b, we'll have a plus b over 2, and that'll be the average. To find the average velocity, we'll have velocity 1 plus velocity 2 over 2, and that'll give us our v average. Assuming you have no acceleration in the x direction, your v1 and v2 should be the same, and therefore your v average is your velocity. The next equation we'll look at is v final equals v initial plus at. This actually comes from the equation for acceleration, because acceleration is equal to the change in velocity over the change in time, or simply t. That delta means the change, or final minus initial, and that comes from the formula acceleration is equal to v final minus v initial over t. If we want to isolate v final from this equation, we multiply both sides by t, and then we add v initial to the other side. Rewriting this equation, we get v final is equal to v initial plus at. In this situation, if you're starting at a velocity of 0, velocity drops out, and that gives us the simplified version, v final is equal to at, or you may also see this simply as v is equal to at, v being the v final. The next equation I want to look at is v final squared is equal to v initial squared plus 2a delta x. For this equation, delta x is your total displacement, so you can also write it as 2a times x final minus x initial. When you find that change in x, you get a distance, so sometimes you'll see this equation incorrectly written with a d, where the d represents the distance, which implies your displacement. Once again, if your initial velocity is 0, that drops out, giving you a simplified version of the equation, v final squared is equal to 2a delta x, or even more simplified, v squared is equal to 2ad. I don't like this form of the equation. I especially don't like when we're not specifying v final, but you may see it this way, so recognize that it is the same thing. And last but not least, the equation that seems to cause the most confusion is delta x is equal to v initial t plus 1 over 2at squared. There are many ways to represent this equation, and while they say the same thing, because they don't look the same, a lot of students get confused. So I want to show you how to relate the different forms to make sure you don't get confused if you see this on your MCAT. The first confusion comes from the way this form of the expression is written. V sub I means V initial, V sub F is V final. But there's another way to write this. If you have V with a little 0, that's V naught, or the starting velocity, which is the same thing as the initial velocity. So if I write this as V naught T, I'm talking about the same expression. Another point of confusion is the X value. Delta X means X final minus X initial. So if I rewrite this as x final minus x initial, and then I want to solve for just x final, I have to bring x initial over to the other side. So I'll do plus x initial for both sides and rewrite the equation as follows. X final, or simply x, is equal to my x initial plus v initial t plus 1 over 2 at squared. This is just a longer way to write it, and most likely if you're working through an MCAT question where you're given velocity and acceleration, we're assuming that you start at x equals 0 and that drops out of the equation. And finally, one more point of confusion is that half. I've often seen the equation written as x is equal to v initial t plus AT squared over 2. This throws off a lot of students. Anytime you have a value or an equation over a number, meaning divided by a number, you can pull that number out and multiply it just by 1 over 2 in this case, which is how we get the 1/2 AT squared. So hopefully now you understand how to relate the different versions of the equation, which brings up the next question. How do you know which equation to use in any given problem? I want you to analyze these equations with me and recognize that we have four main units that we're looking for. Anytime we have a final and initial, we're only looking for the final. So we have a unit for x, or displacement. We have a unit for velocity, specifically v final. We have a unit for acceleration, and we have time. Every equation given has three out of the four units. The first one has x, v, and t, but it does not have acceleration. The second one has v final, we're ignoring v initial, a, and t, but it does not have displacement, or x. The third one has v final, it has acceleration and displacement, but it does not have time. And finally, the last one has displacement. We're ignoring v initial, remember we're looking for v final as our unit. We have acceleration, we have time, we do not have velocity final. In referring to these equations, we can say it has the three given, or we can say it is missing. So for example, the first equation is the acceleration independent equation, the second one is displacement independent, and so on. Anytime you're given a kinematic question, you'll be provided with two units and asked to solve for the third. So the way you can tell which equation to use is identify the two units that you're given, the unit that you're asked to solve, and then see which equation has those three units. So for example, if I tell you to solve for the total distance and I give you velocity and time, I'll see that I'm asked for distance, I'm given velocity and time, but I'm not given acceleration or told to solve for acceleration. So why would I consider a unit that I really have no use for? In that situation, we solve for the acceleration independent equation. Now, one thing I want you to keep in mind, everything here is written out for the x components, but if you have y, you can swap it out. X becomes y, and acceleration becomes the acceleration of gravity at 10 meters per second squared. Keeping all of this in mind, I want you to go back to my kinematic videos where I walk you through examples of velocity, displacement, acceleration, freefall, projectile motion, and I want you to consider the individual problems and see how I determined what we're given, what we're asked for, what we're not asked for, and therefore quickly narrow down the equation to use. You can find my entire series on translational motion by visiting my website, layupforsci.com/mcatphysics.
Are you stuck on a specific MCAT topic? I offer private online tutoring where I focus on your needs to strengthen your individual weaknesses. Tutoring details can be found using the link below or by visiting my website, layupforsci.com/mcattutor. Are you overwhelmed by the sheer volume of information required for the MCAT? Are you worried that lack of a proper study plan and low MCAT score will prevent you from getting into medical school? My new ebook, The MCAT Exam Strategy, a 6-week guide to crushing the MCAT, will help you formulate a concrete study plan by helping you figure out where you stand now, identify your goals, and figure out what it takes to reach them. And it's yours free when you sign up for my email newsletter at mcatexamstrategy.com. By signing up for my email newsletter, you'll also be the first to know when I have new videos, MCAT study guides, cheat sheets, tips, and so much more. The link again, mcatexamstrategy.com.